And then a beauty queen. Nothing more spectacular than a beauty pageant. Well, watch out, Miss America. These pageant queens are glamorous, beautiful men. That's right. Today, these stunning beauty queens who were born men are going to tell us why they've decided to live as women. They'll also dazzle you with their glittering style, feminine grace, and glamorous costumes. And now, here they are, our beauty queens. Bring them on out.
Continental USA. I hope that you enjoy the show, and by all means, enjoy me. DeMilo, all the way from Fort Lauderdale, Florida. I hope you enjoyed the Jerry Springer Show, and I hope you won't forget it because it's one you will never forget. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Danielle Hunter, and I come to you from Nashville, Tennessee, and welcome to the New Age of Illusion. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Cezanne, a former Miss USA 1990 and Miss Black America 1992. Hi. Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Kelly Anderson. I was first alternate to Miss Continental. And remember this afternoon, it's not what you do see that counts, it's what you don't.
My name is Sheri Payne. I'm a former Miss Gate Continental Chicago and a former Miss Illinois. Play my role, get ready for Miss Cosmo.
Good evening. My name is Tandi Andrews. I'm a former Miss Continental USA, Miss Gay USA, and I am the reigning Miss Gay National. Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Mimi Marks. I'm a former Miss Continental USA, and I'd like to give a special hello to all my family in Iowa. Thank you.
And there you have them. How about that, huh? You are... Let me say right off the bat, you are all absolutely beautiful. Okay. But help me out, because, and I should get helped out right here in the beginning, because I said you're all beautiful, because I didn't know whether to say, hey, you guys are really beautiful, or what do you want to be called? What are you?
We're female impersonators.
So you are men.
Technically, most of us are preoperative transsexuals, which means we're the furthest you can go with altering your body to look like a woman. Without the final surgery.
Exactly.
Being that is the case, that we are preoperative transsexuals, of course we've fought for a very long time to look like we do, and we do prefer being called women because that's how we live our lives.
Okay, now let me get through the physical stuff first, and then we'll get into what goes through your emotions. Well, you can tell where my mind is, huh? But you're laughing because you're wondering the same thing. Okay. When you say preoperative, that means it's below the waist, you are still
male.
Men.
Male.
Still male. Are you okay, ma'am? This woman's having a tough time. Okay, it's going to be okay. It's going to be okay.
Than
all right. What is it? On top, obviously you have breasts. Is this, are these implants or do you take hormones or
female hormones?
Female hormones. I started when I was in ninth grade. The summer of ninth grade, I started hormone therapy and development came as you see now.
Yeah, you're beside yourself, ma'am. What is it that?
I don't know.
Have you ever seen anything like this before?
No.
Never have. I think her reaction is the reaction of a lot of people who see it for the first time. Let me tell you a personal story. I just walked into the green room prior to the show, as I normally do, just to say hi to folks. And I was stunned because you were at the time in various stages of undress. And I didn't know, I'll tell you what honestly went through my mind. I didn't know how to react. Should I have blushed because I was in the room with women getting changed?
Yeah.
And then
yes.
I said to myself, why am I blushing? These are guys, you know, and it's all okay. This confusion, most of us have to deal with all
but
the time.
But your first impressions is the one you went with, right? Women.
Okay. What do you think of other women?
I think women take their beauty for granted. It's not something that's given to you. I think women should sometimes put a little more effort into what they do to achieve a perfect look. That's what perfection is all about. We spend a lot of time to prepare for this. Of course, this is not what we look like every afternoon. There's not this much entailed, but I think if women put a little more effort in it, they would get a lot more response.
When you were growing up, did you think of yourself as a boy or a girl?
I was a boy, but my family, when I was growing up, there were no male figures around. So basically it was my mother, her girlfriends, and me. So I became one of the girlfriends.
Yeah. Yes.
Do you guys have sex with men or with women?
Men.
Men.
Are they surprised at any point?
Well, you must inform them.
Yeah.
It's not something that you can just say, by the way, pass me the salt and I'm a man.
Okay, I'll tell you what.
You know, okay. you have to inform them. It's only fair.
I think it's also healthy.
It's a tough Here's, game to play.
Let me suggest, I tell you what, we're going to deal with this. Let's take a break now, because later these beauty queens will appear in the bathing suit and evening gown events. But first, we're going to deal with a question that was just raised. What happens when a man falls in love with a woman who's really a man? We're going to find out next. Please stay with us.
I was on a date with her sister, saw this beautiful woman come in, and wanted to get to know about her. I soon found out that this was her brother, Jeff.
Welcome back. Today we're talking to men who live as women and have even won beauty pageants. Now, right now, I want you to meet Danielle's boyfriend, Michael, Amy's boyfriend, John, and Tandy's boyfriend, Ronnie. I'm going to start with you, Michael. How did you two meet, and what is it like to be in love with a woman who is a man?
Well, actually, when Danielle and I first met, I met her as a female. I didn't know any different. And I was on a date with her sister, her younger sister.
Who is, in fact, a woman.
Who is, in fact, a woman.
Okay.
I dated women all my life until I met Danielle. I was on a date with her sister, saw this beautiful woman come in, and wanted to get to know more about her. I soon found out that this was her brother, Jeff, that I was actually talking to.
Okay. Now, let me stop you right there, because my guess would be, if I were attracted to this woman and I start, you know, talking to her and I take her out to dinner and I liked her and all that, if she suddenly, was this what, like the second date, the third date, a couple of weeks later?
No, actually, I found out the same night that I met her.
Okay.
Didn't start dating immediately.
But if she suddenly said to you, and then I won't interrupt anymore.
Okay.
If she suddenly said to you, you know, you're really a cute guy and you're really nice, but I got to tell you, I'm a guy, wouldn't the... And I don't want to say normal reaction as if there's something bad about not being normal, but I'm going to say what the majority of people are. Wouldn't that normal reaction be, gosh, excuse me. I mean, you wouldn't be rude. You wouldn't say anything bad, but you say, oh, well, hey, nice to go. Maybe one day we'll go to a ball game. I mean.
Right. It was strange at first. I went through, and I think probably most everyone on the panel went through a time early in the stages where you're confused. You don't understand. You want to date this beautiful woman, but there's something about her that She's not a woman. You don't understand why you're attracted to her. Through growth and just getting to know the person, I fell in love with her. I've been with her for 6 years now. You get by the little things that happen every day, and you just, if you love someone, it doesn't matter.
And, well, let me ask a question. Are you gay?
I don't feel like I am. I have a lot of gay friends. I've always been open-minded. I go to gay clubs to watch her perform, but I've never been attracted to men.
But she's a man.
Right.
So at some point,
psychologists could write books on the subject. Yeah. I don't understand it myself all the time.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
I've dated women my whole life. I come from a very...
You've dated what your whole life?
I've dated women my whole life.
Okay.
I come from a very strict family background, prior service members, Marines, the whole bit. And I was always raised as, a fag basher. And until I got away from my family and got into living on my own, I went to school, I started to realize that it's not that way. It's not right. And I had met Amy. I had seen her a couple times at a club. And then I had just introduced myself. And what I saw was a woman who was more woman than any woman I've ever seen. Acted more like a woman, talked more like a woman, softer. It just kind of blew my mind. And the thought didn't really come across my head that, though.
So you're attracted to Amy because, not because Amy's a man.
No, she's very feminine. She's more feminine than women I've been. When I think I've been with some quite pretty women, feminine women.
Same experience with you?
Right. Like, I got to know Tandi. I met her out at a club on her turf, as usual. And so we got to know each other. And before sex or anything became an issue, we got to know each other. And I fell in love with her, not what was between her legs.
Thank you, darling.
Yes. Yes, I understand that. But at some point, as the relationship developed, wouldn't that start to make a difference? If before that, you had never been out with a man in a...
If we weren't comfortable with each other, it might be. But at some point, you have to get comfortable. Sex is a very intimate thing.
Yes.
And
that's certain people... We wanted to get to know each other to find out
if we even wanted to waste the time to have sex. If we didn't like each other, we weren't going to do it.
Right.
Do you want Tandi to change over totally to a woman?
No, I'm happy with the way she is.
I don't really want to be a woman right now.
Okay.
What did your sister say when she lost you?
Oh, my sister? Well, that's how my mother and my family found out about me. I mean, she had a fit, so of course she told the whole family the whole story. And
we weren't exactly dating. We had just gone out a few times. We were more friends than anything else, and I met Danielle through her.
I mean, after 6 years, she realizes that it was us that was meant to be together, not her.
Since all you guys are decent looking, doesn't it make it kind of hard when you guys go to a bar and see a female? And, I'm not saying anything bad about you guys because you're all beautiful, but doesn't it make it hard when you see, real females?
Do you have a boyfriend?
Kind of, not
Does
really.
It make it hard for him when he goes out to a club to see other females?
Well, yeah, but it's different.
It's all about commitment.
It's not.
It's the same.
It's commitment.
It's,
I commit myself
commitment.
To her, so I'm not going to...
You're confusing sex with love. There's a big difference.
Yes.
Hi, Tandi's boyfriend, I'm sorry, I don't remember your name.
Ron.
He was talking about how he got to know her first, and he likes her, loves her for who she is and not between what's her legs. I just wanted to ask, this might be kind of personal, but how do you look so good in those dresses? I mean, I could never tell you were men, because there's...
You'll ask the question, you know what, you're going to ask the question more when they're in the bathing suits.
You mean, what do we do with it?
Basically, yeah. Thank you.
If you're a woman that's slightly heavier, then you try to camouflage it. You've got to hide your flaws, darling. It's just a small flaw for me.
I'm just...
Literally.
I'm bewildered at where I would hide it. I mean...
Well, have a harder time than
I'm not talking about that, but I'm... Okay. Well, hold on to your hats, or in this case, wigs, because when we come back, our men, women are coming out in their bathing suits, and we're going to answer your question. So stay with us.
Has your child been so out of control that you've had to turn them into the police? If you'd like to be part of our panel or audience, call us at 1-800-29-JERRY.
Welcome back. One of the most critical moments of a transsexual beauty pageant has to be the swimsuit competition. So please welcome back to the stage our beauty queens, and here they are.
Hi, I'm Monica, and I love being a woman because I find the female body to be a form of art.
I believe the two most beautiful things that God has created is women in flowers. The most beautiful thing man has created is a female impersonator.
I believe that women are beautiful creatures, and that is why I am a woman.
Hello, I'm Cezanne. My greatest inspiration for being a woman was my mom.
My name is Kelly, and I love being a woman because as a man, I was limited, but now I'm limitless.
Hello, my name is Sheri Payne. I like being a woman because I can.
My name is Tandi, and I love being a woman because I don't have to pay for dinner.
Hello, I'm Mimi. I love being a woman because I hated being a boy.
Here, I'm telling you, maybe someone in the audience can help me out, but I'm not just... Yeah. Holy cow. Here, sir. Yeah.
You said holy cow?
Yeah, holy cow. I don't believe it. Cross my heart and hope to die. You look, all of you look so beautiful. Are you really male?
They don't make men like they used to, do they?
No. My God, I don't believe it.
Yeah, well, believe it.
For the rest of the show, you're just going to have to take their word, but I'm telling you, they really are all men. I mean, they still all have the parts of a male, and yet it's pretty hard to tell, isn't it?
I was waiting for one of them to ask me whether or not I was a man.
You know what? I'm going to take your word for it. Okay. Thanks. You said you didn't like being a boy when you came out here. Why didn't you like being a boy?
Because you get, when you're a boy that looks like a girl, you're constantly being ridiculed.
How did you look
teased.
Like a girl as a kid? I mean, that was before you had the transplants or the hormone or whatever.
I just had very feminine features and very feminine.
It's hard to be
mannerism.
Feminine in society today because they have already labeled you as a fag. And if you don't feel like one, it's really difficult to go anywhere and feel comfortable. Dressed like a woman, if you're already feminine, comes so easily. I mean, it just...
So you're saying that you feel less discrimination, in a sense, going all the way and becoming a woman rather than being a homosexual male?
Much
definitely.
Less.
Much
more comfortable. Because of the way we look, the way we're perceived by an audience or by people in general... is by our first appearance, and our first appearance is as a woman, and therefore, if we were to be living as men, it wouldn't come across the same. We would still be ridiculed because they would be more confused if we were living as boys and still very feminine looking than achieving this goal,
sure,
and at least having something for them to choose. Now they can say male or female.
We fit into society a little bit
better. Yes. I'm interested in knowing, you dress like a woman all the time. Where you live, do your neighbors and your landlady and everybody know that you're really...
They do.
They know now.
They do now.
All right, thank you.
What do you guys do, or girls, I'm sorry, what do you do for a living other than these pageants? Do you have a regular job?
I work at a club here in Chicago called The Baton at night, and during the day I work in a hair salon.
Well, that's cool. So you, like, that anyone else?
And some of us, for instance, the reason we enter the pageants in the first place, the pageants are a form of our livelihood. And being that you are, say, Miss Continental USA, clubs across the country who do shows with female impersonators want your entertainment in their club.
And the money's getting, the money is getting better. I mean,
and this is a career. This is, it's just as if some people go into law school, this is an art form, and it's what we choose to do as a career. The money is phenomenal.
Yeah, I was just curious.
Yes. Will any of you make the final decision to have the last operation?
For me, right,
I
can't wait.
Or why?
You're just trembling saying the last operation.
Why or why not will you decide
you
to do that?
You have your checkbook. I'm ready.
So it costs, it's an expensive, it just costs a lot of money.
You also have to consider that it's going to affect not only you, your family. You have to inform everybody that's, you know, surrounding you what's going on. It's a life-changing thing.
Are your family supportive of you?
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
There was no resistance in the beginning.
Well, I mean, that's the thing. You need to tell when someone is becoming a transsexual. I think one of the most important things is you have to inform your family. You can't throw this on them. It's a big shock to find out that your son wants to be a woman. So
they didn't try and talk you out of any of you?
It's a big shock for them to find out that when I told my parents I was gay to begin with, that was the first devastation, but then to have this come along afterwards. Luckily, I was an only child, and my parents had really nothing else to do but deal with it. My father and I don't speak very often. As a matter of fact, we haven't spoken in about 10 years. But
is it because of that? Because of that?
And he has another wife, and she had children, and he chose. We'd had a big discussion about it, and rather than me grow up hating him and him avoiding me, we had a discussion to where he didn't understand my lifestyle, and rather than me force it on him, he went his way, I went mine, and therefore there's still a peace and a common bond between the two of us where there's no hostility.
Mine does not accept it at all.
Your family doesn't accept it at all?
No, they won't. It's to the point now I can't go home. I mean, they're all very lucky. I mean, I hope that someday she'll accept me the way I am, but as right now she does not.
I wanted to ask you, how long does it take you to put on your makeup, and is that your real hair?
Yeah.
It's all individual. I mean, some girls, I know girls that do their makeup in 5 minutes, and I know girls who take 2.5 hours.
If you, before you, when you just go out to the grocery store, obviously.
Oh, please.
Before, this is show makeup. Like, for every day, it's just maybe a little.
Okay, now, when you're just going out to the grocery store, are you looking more like a
male?
We
go like this.
No.
No, I'm talking.
Just every day.
What do you mean? Right into the express line.
I mean, in other words, do people look closely at your face and you don't have all the beautiful bathing suits and the makeup and the hair up?
Actually, probably less so, because if you look in the audience at the women are not painted out of their mind and yanked with hair and wearing bikinis and high heels every day. You're going to draw more attention to yourself the sexier and the more overdone you look.
So we look pretty normal.
So you don't have someone coming up to the grocery counter going,
I look like that's a guy. You're convincing, but there are some people that just are perceptive people that can tell. You know, like most of the other gay people, but some straight people, we have a joke that children can tell.
Children. We get very comfortable with our voices sometimes. And by doing that, children are so observant. They look, they'll run to their parents and go, Mommy, that's a man.
Is that a man?
Yeah.
Mommy, that's a man. And then we just went to the other side of the grocery store.
Exactly.
First of all, I want to say you guys all are beautiful. And it's kind of sad that you guys can look better than a lot of women out there. But I also want to know, do you ever have that motherly instinct? And do any of you wish to have kids at any time?
Well, I think it would be a miracle. I would love to. Guinness Book of Records is not ready for that.
Yeah, no, but you could adopt. You
yes, we could adopt. They do such extensive research into your background after you have your surgery. To adopt a child, I think there's plenty of children who need good homes, and I don't think they should put such strict regulations
on. But they do.
But they do, and the minute they go deep enough into your background and find out that you were once born a man,
exactly.
I think they tend to deprive a child of a very good parent because of something
they
so
feel
minor.
That you're mentally unstable.
Okay. Coming up next, we have the talent competition. That's right. Two of our bathing beauties are going to sing. Please stay with us. Another pageant, another key portion of a transsexual beauty pageant is the talent competition. Well, performing her rendition of Moving On Up, welcome back the reigning Miss Continental, Monica Munro.
Your time is up. You took a sip from the devil's cup. You broke my heart. There's no way back. Move right out of here, baby. Go pack your bags. Just who do you think you are? Stop acting like some kind of star. Just who do you think you are? Take it like a man, baby, if that's what you are. Cause I'm moving on up. You're moving on out. Moving on up. Nothing can stop me. Moving on up. You're moving on out. Time to break free. Nothing can stop me. They brag on me. Has walked in space, but you can't even find my place. There's nothing you can do, cause I've had enough of me, baby, being part of you. Just who do you think you are? This time you've gone too far.
You were dying. I've never seen a guy so uncomfortable being at a show, huh? You're very good. Excellent.
But if he had known, he would have smiled a little bit harder.
Yes. There you go. That's probably true.
That's probably true.
How important is the entertainment part of the pageant?
Very honestly, probably the most important part of any contest, because most of the contest, it is the highest scored category of competition. So no matter how beautiful you are, how beautiful your body is or whatever, that's going to be the category that's going to really pull you through is your personality and your costuming.
Okay, well, we're going to have now a costume parade.
An array of costumes with all
okay.
our girls. Starting off with Mimi. Mimi gives us a beautiful black and white bustier, showcasing her lovely body and her flawless talent. Mimi's a dancer, a former Miss Continental USA, among many other titles. Can you top that? Next we have Sheri. Sheri's wearing a yellow cat suit with caging. Sheri's a dancer, a fabulous dancer. Right? The legs are up to there.
Up to where? Oh, yeah, yeah.
Up to everywhere. You don't want to know up to where. That's Sheri. And we have my first alternate in Miss Continental, and that's Kelly. Kelly's wearing a beautiful black dress. Kelly's known for giving attitude on stage and showcasing her talent with grace and attitude. Lots of it. Next, we have Danielle, another redhead in our cast. Danielle is wearing a lovely pink chiffon creation with feathers and rhinestones. That one's a shocker. And we bring Amy. Amy currently lives in Florida and showcases us with fuchsia. Sparkle. Next we have Tandi. Tandi's known for being sexy and glamorous. She's giving us a hot pan creation with gold beadwork and gold thigh-high boots. And last and certainly not least, we have Cezanne wearing a retro 70s colored leotard.
Okay, performing Naughty Girls, here is Miss Gay USA 1990, Cezanne.
You still
Queens, it's what you'll see next in our evening gown competition. Don't go away. Hi, I'm Jerry Springer, inviting you to join me Monday for the Jerry Springer Show. I'm not going to tell you what the show's about. You'll just have to tune in Monday and find out. So I'll see you back here Monday.
Everybody
ready? Okay, Steve, yeah. Monica's right here. Welcome back. I'm here with Monica Munro, the reigning Miss Continental. The Miss Continental pageant is the most prestigious of transsexual beauty pageants, and the evening gown competition is the most important part of that pageant, and I guess I should ask you, why is that so?
Well, it's all about glamour, and of course, anyone that they're going to want representing a national title such as Miss Continental, they're going to want, you know, want to have nice gowns and to look beautiful in them.
Yeah, and let me just keep saying, in case someone just tuned in, I'm standing next to a man, okay, so you understand that. All right, now, what are we about to see?
We're about to see some of the most beautiful female impersonators in the country and some of the most beautiful evening gowns you'll ever see.
Great, let's take a look.
We're going to start off with Amy DeMilo. Amy's wearing a beautiful red beaded creation. If that wouldn't send some hearts chilling, I don't know what would. Lovely. Thank you, Amy. Now we have Tandi Andrews. Tandi is the reigning Miss National USA as well as a former Miss Gay USA and former Miss Continental USA. She's had them all. And with gowns like that, we can see why. Next, we have Cezanne. Cezanne is wearing a beautiful Bob Mackie creation in white and gold. She's a former Miss USA and Miss Black America. Now we have Kelly Anderson in bright yellow. What a better way to accent that beautiful red hair than with a yellow gown. Beaded gown that's also backless, giving us a little leg and a little back. She'll be also vying for the title of Miss Continental USA this year. Now we have Danielle Hunter. Danielle brings us a beautiful black and gold gown. It gives just the right amount of leg. Mimi Marks. She's a former Miss Continental USA, and we can see why.
Okay, let's bring them all out. How about that? Here they are, eight of the most beautiful men you'll ever see, huh? Monica, Mimi, Sheri, Cezanne, Kelly, Danielle, Amy, and Tandi, you all look gorgeous. Okay, we'll take a break and come back with your questions right after this.
For your free tickets to the Jerry Springer Show in Chicago, write Jerry Springer, tickets, Post Office Box 4115, Chicago, Illinois, 60654. Or call 312-321-5365.
come back, yes.
If the government instituted a draft, which sector of the armed forces would they serve in?
If the government instituted a draft, which sector of the armed forces would you serve in? I'm pretty sure they wouldn't get to serve in any of them.
Right. And I no.
Yeah, I just remember okay. when we did have a draft, what it was like, and I'm not making any disparaging remarks. I'm just saying.
Oh, they made plenty to me when I registered.
Oh, they did? Well, tell me about it.
I just went in and they said, well, no, you have to, he has to come in on his own. And I went, okay, I just need a form. Please give me the form. I know what I'm doing. He goes, well, if it's for your brother or family member, you have to have him come in and sign. I went, look, it's like this. I'm a boy and I'm registering because it's the law. Now give me the thing and let me go. And I know he just stamped it and stamped it and stamped it when I was gone.
Yes.
I think it's time to ask the inevitable. Where do you put it and how do you put it there?
The inevitable.
It's there, but it's like a trade secret. For us.
Well,
you wouldn't want to do it.
Right. Be thankful.
We just push it away. Get rid of it.
Take a deep breath.
Tight panties.
Can't sit in his seat very long, put it that way.
Okay, so at least we know the direction. Okay, yeah. Well, you know, that answers the question. Yeah.
You guys said that you were taking hormone pills earlier, and what kind of medical effects is that going to have in the future, like 20, 30 years from now?
Well, none that I know of. You know,
there's been tested. They haven't done many tests on men on what it does to our bodies in the future, but it does produce cancer in women, although it's cancerous of the uterus predominantly, which is something we don't have to worry about. So side effects are just predominantly genital shrinkage and breasts.
Yes.
How long does it take you to get ready in the morning? Is there a lot of upkeep? To your bodies, makeup, hair?
We don't do this every day. I mean, meaning the makeup and the hair.
We
get up, put on jeans, t-shirts, and grab the car keys and hit it.
Was there ever a point in your life, even as young children, that you were interested in women as opposed to men?
Just as good girlfriends.
Only as idols.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And friends and confidants.
I think that I was interested in women primarily because out of denial. You know, you think to yourself, I want to be a girl so bad, and you're so obsessed with women and everything about being a woman. It was just on my mind 24 hours a day. And trying to reject that and growing up in a small town with a family that you were worried about what they thought. And, you know, you try to reject it and you try to go out with girls and date them and you end up just being best friends and doing their hair.
If you weren't involved in any of this, let's say you had never seen anyone do this before and it never even entered your mind, would you all be gay?
I suppose so.
That's how we got it. Yeah, that's how this started.
So you go from a transition.
Sexually, probably we were all gay in the beginning.
I see. That's the question.
And then it transformed into this.
Yeah, I guess to each his own. But your decision to be women obviously has to affect a lot of guys.
That's where I think you're wrong. You say decision.
It's not a choice.
For me, there was never a decision. It was either be miserable for the rest of my life or kill myself or be a girl. You know, there was no choice in my mind.
You were born, you're straight, you're heterosexual. You were born liking women. We were born liking men.
And wanting to be a
woman. But we were boys.
Identifying with
women. It's not something that somebody taught us.
Exactly.
Or somebody made us.
We didn't wake up in the morning and go,
We were this way, just like you were, the way you are.
Okay.
This is just the way we were born.
Did any of you guys have any kind of plastic surgery? Because I would think that you taking the hormones, you can get breasts that it would make the rest of you kind of fat. So do you
it
guys
does.
Get
have to work
it
out?
Does, but you exercise and you have to watch what you do, especially being competitors.
But
you
this
know,
is why we chose to live like this for me because I've always been feminine. My structure and my body build. I mean, like say you have so many genes in your body. Some genes are more dominant, male genes.
But is it
genes.
Okay? But is it fair to say, and I won't ask either any of you because that's personal. But is it fair to say that up on the stage, at least some of you have had a surgery on your breasts?
I just have had about everything physically altered.
Oh, well, you're
but
blunt.
But not surgically.
Okay.
Not surgically.
Well,
no,
not
but surgically. With the hormones, there is.
In other words, you haven't had breast
silicone treatment.
No. Yeah.
Yes
no,
or no?
No.
No one's had breast implants.
No.
That's it. Well, we're going to take a break, and I'll be back with a final thought in just a moment.
If you want to order a video cassette of Jerry's show for only $24.95, call Video Archives at 1-800-FOR-VIDEO, 1-800-FOR-VIDEO for your videotape. For a transcript, Send $5 with program name, date, and subject to Burrell's Transcripts, Box 7, Livingston, New Jersey, 07039. Or call 1-800-777-TEXT.
Take this opportunity to thank all of you for being with us today. You are the best looking group of men I think that any of us have seen. Good luck to all of you in the decisions you've made and in your careers. Sure. Yes. You know, in this competitive world of television ratings, I'm tempted to tell you that I used to be a woman, the revelation of which would most certainly place me on the cover of People and a guest shot on everybody else's talk show. But of course, that's not true. I'm a guy. I've always been a guy. And ever since puberty, when Annette Funicello started replacing Yogi Berra posters on my bedroom wall, I never questioned that I would always be a guy. And I didn't have to look in the mirror to have that assurance. But what if I didn't have that assurance? What if, despite the appendages to my body, in my mind, I felt like and believed I was really a woman? Should a body part dictate who I am, what I am? If a baby's born with a defective heart or liver or blind or without a limb, we embrace the infant, love him or her, hold a telethon, and do whatever it takes to bring comfort. We don't say, too bad, that's what God intended, let's not correct the problem, and hate the kid for trying to fix the defect. Then why do we get so upset if the defect relates to gender? If our guests today have body parts that don't relate to who they are, why can't they fix that? Maybe the point here is not to judge a person until you've walked a mile in his shoes, even if they are high-heeled. Till next time, take care of yourself and each other.
You want regular cheddar cheese with all that fat, cholesterol, and calcium?